Welcome to the world premiere of the FXX original series, You're the Worst.
So he just never came home from proposing? He just disappeared?
Maybe he moved back to England.
This modern look at love and happiness follows a group of friends who have had no success with either.
Isn't it kind of awesome, though, that I came straight here after Jimmy left me on that hill and haven't left? Like, that is pretty much straight baller when you think about it!
This new season resets the relationships. We asked about taking the characters in a new direction.
Jimmy has made the worst mistake of his life in proposing to Gretchen and then leaving her on top of a hill, then disappearing for 3 months.
This season is an exploration of that period in every relationship where things get really rocky. This is just, you know, the Jimmy and Gretchen version of it. They do everything big.
Are you okay?
Yeah, no, it's just I'm not really going outside these days.
What do you mean?
I haven't left your apartment.
Since when?
3 months? 2 days, give or take.
What?
The new season switches things up a little bit. Gretchen's heartbroken and self-medicating, and she's become agoraphobic. But you've got some new romances and some completely switched character reversals, it feels like. Lindsay's responsible. Who knew?
Lindsay is paying her rent. She has a job. She's dedicated to bettering herself. And there's a moment where Edgar and Lindsay realize we're the serious ones now. You and me, we have jobs now. We are business people. We're the serious ones now.
Oh my God.
Jimmy and Gretchen used to be kind of the reliable, responsible ones, I guess you can say, of the group. But now, like, Lindsay and I, we have jobs. We start having some friends with benefits sort of action, and it kind of seems like we're the ones with our together, and they're just kind of, you know, floating in the mist.
Don't play with me. Come on, I'm Gretchen.
Stop bothering me. All right, fine, I'll kiss you, Jesus.
Well, do me already, dummy.
Fine.
We're back at the world premiere of the FXX original series, You're the Worst.
The DVD selection is pathetic here.
But what do you expect from a town whose tax money all goes to opioid treatment and bark beetle eradication?
We wanted to know how the character changes inspired the cast.
I haven't spent a lot of time with the rest of the cast this year because my storylines have been very much separate with different guest artists and things, which has been very lucky from my point of view. But all four of us have been on our own journey, and we're getting to the end of the season now where they're all coming together again, and it feels like we've really earned it.
You know, one thing that's hard with the changes is that we seem like we're on four very different stories this season, so we didn't get to see each other a lot. So personally, that sucks because I love them and they're some of my best buds. But artistically, it's nice because we get to solidify these personal stories.
I work a lot with Heather and barely see Chris and Des this season. There are moments when Heather says to me, oh, I'm so boring in this scene, and I say, oh, I'm so overacting in this scene, because we're used to playing the opposite roles. So there's a little bit of that.
I'm not used to being the straight man in scenes, and she's not used to being kind of like the kooky, zany one. And it was nice to get to do different things as actors that we aren't used to.
What are we gonna do now?
Have you been out here the whole time?
Yeah, just like 3 hours. You told me to wait outside. I introduced this cabbie to Jack FM. He loves it.
Chris, if you could be the worst, what would you love to say or do?
I think I'd love to get out of my car in the LA traffic and tell everyone what I thought of them. I'm not even driving on the way here and I get angry.
I would love to say really mean things to certain politicians into camera. But I'm with dirty words, but I'm not going to.
Well, I mean, Keather already got to stab somebody, so I guess we'll take that one out of the list.
I wish I could just tell someone off, like, in the moment and not think of it later.
I just eat Taco Bell every day without consequence. I think that's probably what I do.
Hey, do you know where those Eskimo pies are that I put in the freezer?
Oh, I forgot to tell you, the police came for them.
Weird.
For FXM, I'm Tava Smiley. Thanks for watching.